Hello everyone, I'm Priyansh and today we are talking about the Big Bang again. The universe arose from the Big Bang, before which all of the universe was contained into a single point of infinite density, except it was not. This is true that when we use Einstein's theory of general relativity to predict how the universe would have been in the past, we do get a singularity at time equals zero, into which all of universe was contained. But there are strong reasons behind why this doesn't have to be true. The theory we use to predict the evolution of the universe is general relativity, which is, despite being extremely accurate, incomplete, and we know that it breaks down at small length scales. At small length scales, quantum effects become increasingly important, and we know that purely classical general relativity will give us a wrong picture about the universe. So what we need is the theory of quantum gravity, a theory that can describe our universe in such small, dense and hot state, a theory that unifies the laws of general relativity with quantum mechanics. So the idea of the universe starting out from a point of infinite density is most probably not true, because it is based on a theory that we know does not work in those regimes. But there have been attempts to come up with ideas about this early state of the universe, like by string theory, which in theory unifies the laws of general relativity with quantum mechanics. In string theory, things can't be extremely small. There is a cutoff. So according to string theory, the universe in the most optimistic case be of Planck length, but no smaller. So no singularities. And after that, the usual picture of the Big Bang takes over. But we don't know if string theory truly describes our universe or not. And there have been other attempts, such as by loop quantum gravity and others. We are confident about how the universe was down to about 10 to the negative 32 seconds after the Big Bang, at which point a thing called inflation stopped. And we are pretty sure that the Big Bang picture is very close to being correct, at least to this point in our Big Bang timeline from now. Using cosmic microwave background radiation, which is essentially the map of the universe when it was around 380,000 years old, and by recreating the conditions as it was just after the Big Bang in particle accelerators, using these, we are pretty sure how the universe was like just after the Big Bang, like very close to Big Bang. But the energies necessary to create conditions even earlier than that is so far not in our reach. So we really don't know much about the universe when it was very small in age. The universe is big, so it's hard to think of the entire universe to be compressed into a very small volume. Well, the entire universe was never confined into such small volumes. The entire universe may as well be infinite. And if it was infinite in size, it would have been infinite in size always. The thing we mean when we say that the universe was once smaller than this or smaller than that, we are in reality talking about the observable universe, which is for sure finite in size. It's about 46.5 billion light years in radius. And the observable universe is only a tiny part of the entire universe. The entire universe may as well be infinite, as previously said. We really don't know. So what is this observable universe? Well, the observable universe is the part of the entire universe which we can see. If you think about that, it's very simple in theory. Given that the universe is 14 billion years old and that light travels at a finite speed, there would be regions of space from which light would not have had time to reach us. These regions would be the part of the unobservable universe because we are not able to observe them. And the part of the universe which you can observe is the part of the observable universe. Then you might say, if the universe is 14 billion years old and light travels at the speed of light, the edge of the observable universe must be 14 billion light years in radius. Why is it 46.5 billion light years in radius? Well, the answer is, the universe is expanding. So objects from which we can once been able to take light from are now, because of the expansion of the space, are now stretched out to far away distances. So because of that, we are being able to observe objects that are now far away. This is how, even after the universe being 13.8 billion years old, the edge of the observable universe is 46.5 billion light years. So the universe which we were talking about in the first part of the video was actually the observable universe. So picturing Big Bang as a region of space expanding to nothingness is most probably not accurate. And it's more like a region of space expanding into itself, and not only that region of space, but every region of space in the entire universe expanding into itself. Okay, so that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.